Good morning everybody and welcome back to my channel. On popular demand, today I would like to try out before you my version of the singara or samosa. So it's a particular delicacy, something that every Indian swears by. So because of the lockdown period where we do not have any access to some of the singaras or samosas or outside, you know, we're talking about restaurants. So I thought of trying it out at home. So these are the basic ingredients. So normally I follow these ingredients by the gram. It's very, very important that you are careful with how much of maida or the flour that you take, right? So refined flour. So here I have 2 cups of maida, and here I have taken some onion seeds there, or what we call kalonji also. So just throw in this into the mixture. I have here 3/4 teaspoons of salt. This also goes in. I will need here, this is around 1/4 cup of ghee. You can take desi ghee, you can take any ghee, but it should be melted form of the ghee, which also will go inside your the flour there. Now, this particular activity of kneading, it's very important so that your samosas are very crispy and nice. Now you cannot use the spoon there. You really need to use your hands, clean hands, and start doing this. Now what do you do that? You have to mix up in such a manner everything so that the flour, the ghee, the salt, everything actually melts into each other, in fact merges into each other, and completely before we throw in the water. So this step is very important so that your samosas are crispy and nice there, because that's what we run to the hotels for, because we love the crispiness there. So we do not want them to be silent when we eat them. They have to have a crisp when we eat them. So till when do you normally go on doing this? Till you take some in your hands and do this. Yeah, they're coming together. So in a way, they are getting done. In fact, it's done only. I'm talking about the dry ingredients being mixed to each other. Right. Now, even for the water, we have to be careful with the amount of water we put in. So here I have again 1/4 cup of water, which I will slowly put in. I'm using normal water. I'm not using any warm water or anything like that. Just normal water, which I'm going to knead into, right? If you ask me, this is one of the activities I hate doing, but thinking about how my family will love to eat the samosas, I cannot resist but indulge in this activity of kneading the flour, all right? So the entire thing will go in. Apart from that, if they do not come together, you actually have to put in the maximum of 2 more tablespoons of water. That's very important. Just 2 more tablespoons of water. Let me hold it like this. And this is the first tablespoon. And the second tablespoon. Not more than that. This is the amount of water that will go into this kneading, which will now take some more time and call some more of your patience. Now it has been kneading on for, you know, I have actually kneaded it for almost 15 minutes now. Now let me do one thing, put them all together and put it back in the bowl and let it go covered. Now let me show you the other ingredients that we need for the masala that will go inside the samosa. While that's resting, now let us prepare for what will go inside the samosa, or what we call singara, right? And then let us just think how very simple it is. Here I have around 5 big potatoes, which I have just diced in a very, very small as possible that way, right? Okay, apart from that, I have here some green peas. I have taken fresh green peas. If you do not have, you can always avoid, no problem with that. I have here some ground nuts, around 2 tablespoons of ground nut, and around 3 big onions chopped this way. Okay. Apart from that, I'll of course need the favorite here, that is the green coriander leaves, and one red chili, dry red chili, one bay leaf, and some chilies, green chilies, as much as you feel you need the spice, the kick there. Of course, the entire cooking will be done in mustard oil, and let's get cooking. My pan is already heated up, and I'm putting down, say, 1 and 2 big tablespoons of mustard oil. So now let it smoke and let all the raw flavor of the mustard oil disappear before we just put in all the other ingredients that will make those beautiful singaras. I'm already excited about it. So my oil is heated up. I just forgot to mention, I just need a few cumin seeds there, of course. Then I will put in the bay leaf as well as the chili. Almost immediately I'll put in the onion and we fry it. We just want it to caramelize, and of course might be a little bit of brown because we always like the onion a little brown. That's why. So just fry on for some time, constantly stirring on high heat. This will take 2-3 minutes of your constant stirring. Now I'll put in the green chilies there and a little bit of the amount of turmeric that I want in my dish. Now I put in my ground nuts and of course even the green peas. This reminds me of the time when I used to wait for these things to be made at home. I used to be in the hostel. Coming back from the hostel, these were delicacies I would die for. Now there are many others that we serve our sons and daughters, but the nostalgia associated with this still remains. So we'll cook it for some time, just a little, and then we'll drop in the required amount of salt according to your taste. Just spread it across. Be careful, too much of salt will spoil the dish. So keep it in the low and then mix it. Now this is going to go covered and cook itself in very slow flame. It'll take some time, but I want all the potatoes intact in shape. So this is how it looks. I have all my potatoes intact in size, right, in shape, and now it's ready to be going inside the singaras. Of course, I haven't put in the dhania leaves, which is like for the garnish.
So finally, we are done with the, we have the dal ready, and we have the masala that will go inside the singara ready. So I just wanted to tell you that there is a particular way you need to actually roll out the dal. Say for instance, when you have this dal in your hand, instead of making it round, we normally try to make it in a long, this way, you know, it's elongated in a manner, right? So we just try to roll out in an elongated manner, this way. So you roll on this much, say it's, see, quite a long thing, then in between you cut off. Right, so you take the dal, the amount of quantity should be so much that it will make 2 samosas or singaras. The other part you just keep it covered, otherwise it will dry up. So take one piece there, have some water in a bowl. All right, see, this is the elongated piece, the way you had cut in there, you just put some water and roll it and give it a curve like this. Okay, so this will be the top part of your singara, and then put in the mixture. Press in the mixture a bit so that you have enough, every bite will have enough of the masala. Then try to again put some water on the sides so that they stick on, and then cover up to form the base of the singara. See, this is how you'll have it. Okay, this is the top portion that's there, and then this is the base there. Okay, so this is one there. Let me make with the other and show it to you so that it's clear. The part where you had cut off, there you put some water. Okay, just a little water, and then turn it straight like this. Okay, and then so that you have it sealed there on the top. Here you take it in between your index finger and your thumb, and then put in the mixture, the masala. If you have noticed, this we have kept it completely Assamese sort of. We haven't added any whole masalas, any whole spices. Just we had the onion there. Okay, so press it down a bit. Then take this flap and cover it up. That's your singara ready. Okay, this way. See, this is how you have it. Okay, so first you make all of them. Then we will go in and put in the pan there, because we do not want the oil to heat up too much, right? So this way we'll make for all the other singaras. Meanwhile, I have put up a pan. It's a very deep bottomed pan. So here I have put a lot of oil. Remember, the whole singara needs to soak in the oil completely so that you get the crisp proper. So these are some of the ones that I've made them, right? And the others I still have to make others. But still, remember another thing with the singara is that you have to just drop in a bit of the flour, might be, and see, yes, it's not coming up. That means at that moment only you have to put in the singaras. The oil will heat up along with the singaras cooking up. So you should not put in a very high flame. That way the singaras will not be crispy. Okay, so we'll put as many as possible. And the others, while they cook up, we will go in for the others as well. So you have to be careful. The temperature has to be right. The temperature will have to rise along with cooking of the singaras. That's the way it goes. And this really uses a lot of oil. That's obvious. But once in a blue moon, when you really want to have something crisp, I think this is all right. That much we put in, right? The last one that goes in. So in almost medium flame, not full flame also, we'll put up the singaras and let them cook slowly while I make the others as well. So while that's cooking up, please remember you don't disturb them for 2-3 minutes at least, so that they will cook up in their own flame. I mean the oil will heat up, cooking up the singaras as well. So if you disturb, it's a problem. So let them be there undisturbed. After 2-3 minutes, it's almost now, 2-3 minutes, just will throw in the oil there. Just check how they are looking. See, they are doing up proper. So just give it a nice turn now. Yes. So give it a nice turn there. Slowly do it, because it has to cook on. Everything inside is cooked, but outside, it also has to cook outside, right? So that part also needs to cook up. So just turn a bit slowly. And again, let them be resting for some time. We do not want the oil to heat up too much. So, see, you have this beautiful golden color, a brownish golden sort of. And you know, they are done. See, beautifully fried up. So we'll take them out. And remember, this was always done in low to medium heat. Never increase the heat up at all. Otherwise, they will be completely, you know, from the outside they will burn up, and from the inside also they will not be cooked properly. So that's done, crispy and nice. I have the others now. So I just put in the others, the other lot, the second lot that's there. So slowly they go in completely. You can shut down the flame a bit also, so that you regulate the oil. The ones are also going in there. So as many as possible I'm putting in. I'm not touching them for some time. So I've actually shut down the heat so that, you know, the temperature is equalized and balanced in a way, right? Let them be there like that in closed heat for 2-3 minutes. And after some time, when I feel that the temperature has cooled down, I'll slowly give medium to low heat. So maintaining the temperature is the basic thing as regards the making of the singaras. You can see how crispy they are here. They look so crispy, right? So I will have all of them ready. Then I'll show you the entire lot. You can cook with 2 cups of maida. Right? So we'll wait like this for some time. So that's my platter. Platter full of singaras for you for a nice and warm evening. Now, this is like for 2 cups of maida, I made 19 singaras of this size. So I hope you like this recipe of mine, and do give it a like and thumbs up. And if you want, I'll just try and show it to you by breaking how crispy it looks. See, this is the way it goes. See how crispy, and see, it's beautifully steaming there. So that's the way it should be. Singara should be crisp there, and you should enjoy it right away, straight from the pan. I hope you have a nice evening with my singaras, and do give a like and a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching.